morning. My name is Dana Zook. I'm an area livestock specialist from Enid, Oklahoma. I cover the Northwest District. This morning, I'm going to be talking to you about the tools you need to properly conduct a nitrate test within the office. So what we'd like to tell you to start with is something to cover a table or whatever. If you're in a place where you need to test that you don't want the surface to be damaged, we want you to cover with some newspaper or some sort of brown paper, anything that you have that would cover that and protect that surface. We do encourage you to test it outside, but if you need to, have some covering. So the next tool is very important, is a box cutter. You want a sharp blade that's ready to go, a box cutter to slice that stem in half. Want it to be very sharp, because things that aren't sharp probably are a little bit more dangerous and could cut you. So that's a very important tool. Of course, the difenylamine, a good bottle of difenylamine that's been properly tested for accuracy, so that we do know that it's properly indicating the nitrates. We encourage the use of goggles, because as you know, this is acid and can damage lots of things, so we want you to protect your eyes. Goggles would be important, or some sort of sunglasses or that sort of thing. Gloves, of course, we would encourage you to have. I have one of these boxes in my office just so we can grab. You use them for a variety of things, and so gloves, very important to use. I would encourage that as well. The other thing that a lot of the livestock specialists, a lot of the county educators have, something to wear over their clothing. I don't know about you, but I've damaged quite a few pairs of jeans, so it is important to have some sort of apron. I have a shirt that I wear, an old jean shirt, when I do testing, just in case you do get some on your clothing. So with that, that is the tool lineup that we need to properly test nitrates.
I'm Brian Pugh. I'm the Oklahoma State University Area Agronomy Specialist for Eastern Oklahoma. And I'm going to talk to you a little bit this morning about how to properly test the reagent to make sure that it's working accurately. As Dana mentioned earlier, there are some proper tools that we need to use, safety procedures that we need to follow, and we're going to do that here today. I've already laid the newspaper out. And what I'm going to show you is there is a real simple way that you can go out every year and make sure that your reagent's working. Sometimes we get educators mentioning their reagent is 1 to 2 years old, and this is a way you can test to make sure it's still working correctly. I have here in my hand a pigweed plant. Really, any species of the amaranth family will work for this, because we know that all amaranth species do accumulate nitrates in the lower part of the stem. So simply, you want to go out in the field and sample some of these plants. And as you can see here, I have a couple of these stems prepared and ready to be split so we can test the reagent. Okay, so now we're ready to split a couple of these stems that we've prepared. And I'm going to show you the proper way to do that with your knife. One of the safest ways, the easiest ways, is just to insert that blade into that stem. And then you can pick that stem up and basically move the knife away from you to split the stem. You can alternate that stem around the other way, move your knife the other way, and then you end up with a really nice split stem, and you're not cutting towards yourself. So again, safety is going to come first in this procedure. All right, so the next step, now that we have our stem split, we're ready to test the reagent. And again, remember your safety tools that Dana recommended earlier. We need gloves and goggles at the very bare minimum. Also, maybe that apron that we talked about as well. And now we're ready to apply the reagent to the split stem and make sure that it's still working accurately. So we need to pull a little bit of that up into the eyedropper. Come down onto the lower portion of our stem and apply, without touching the stem, apply some drops of reagent. And there again, you can see the blue starting to show up, which indicates the presence of nitrates. And we would expect that with an amaranth plant or a pigweed plant. And that indicates that our reagent is still good. So even if it's 1, 2, or maybe even 3 years old, that can allow us to know that it's still working, and we can make be confident in our recommendations to producers.
This time we're going to look at whole plant samples, such as something that a producer would bring into the office. What we want to look at is the bottom 18 inches, and I will cut that off. Use some forage shears or something like that, and again, make sure they're sharp. But we would about clip it about right there. All right, set that aside. And what we have here is this bottom 18 inch piece. We will, a lot of times what I do is take these leaves off. And then what we'll do is similar to what Brian showed you how to do is insert the knife into the stem and slice it in half. All right, so you have two halves of that plant here, as you can see. And then what we'll do is get ready to test our forage for nitrates. Make sure you put on your safety goggles. All right, so what we want to do is make sure we maintain that we have gloves on, safety goggles, maintain that dropper above the stem. Do not contaminate that dropper on the stem. And drop it on the plant. What we will find is a lot of times we will see a higher level of nitrates in the nodes of the plant, so we want to make sure we touch those. A few drops from top to bottom of our sample. And as you can see here, this sample of Johnson grass did test for nitrates basically from top to bottom of our sample. So when you're finished testing for nitrates, you want to properly dispose of the forage and the paper that you tested it on. So just roll it up, making sure not to drip it off onto your surface, and then just dispose of it in a dumpster or a trash can that has a plastic liner, and that should be perfect.
Whether you're collecting the sample or you're instructing one of your producers how to collect the sample, it's imperative that you collect a good representative sample to ensure that your test is accurate. What you'll want to do is, much like taking a soil sample, you'll want to take samples from about 10 or 15 areas in this location and collecting one stem at each location. If you have shears, much like we have here, you'll want to select stems that are about 5 feet in height, knowing that they're probably going to contain more of the nitrates than smaller, less mature plants. We're going to want to cut them down as close to the ground as we can. There's not any visible sign, much different than maybe you've heard before. There are no outward signs that'll show nitrates. So we're going to pick one that is about 5 feet in height, much like we have here. We're going to bend down with our shears, cut it at ground height. We have one here. We're going to collect about 10 or 15 more, much like this, and that's what's going to make up our sample. Once you have collected a good random sample, and if you've ran a diphenylamine test and you've made the determination you're going to send a sample to the lab, processing that sample to go to the lab and so that it can be, you can get a qualitative test, you'll want to cut the plants up completely. We've got 15 stems here that we're collecting from random samples across the field. We're going to cut it up into about 3-inch strips. That'll be leaves, stems, and all the entire plant. And we'll just start cutting them up, making sure that we get everything in there, leaves and all. And we're going to collect that on some kind of paper so that we can keep the sample together. Okay, now that we have got the sample processed, it's cut into approximately 3-inch pieces, we're going to start to put it in this forage bag. The sample is not going to fit in this forage bag in its entirety. So we're going to want to quarter this sample up so that we get to keep the sample as random as we can. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to break this sample into about half. Approximately putting half of it on one side, half of it on the other. Now that we've got about half this sample, to quarter it, we're going to take about half of that sample out again so that we got about a quarter of this entire sample together. And that's going to be approximately what we need to fill this forage bag to keep this sample as random as we can so we get a good sample. So we're now at this point, we're going to start to load this sample in the bag, not sorting anything out, making sure we get everything in there, leaves, stems, seed heads, whatever it may be. to keep this sample random. If at this point we get all the sample in the bag and we still have a little room, we can quarter this sample, the remaining sample again, and we can add it in there as well.
Okay, so now we've shown you how to properly test for nitrates in your forage. We should talk just a little bit about what happens if we have an accident with the indicator. Maybe we spill some in an outside area or an office area. And one of the best things to do is simply take a shovel full of dirt, add it to this acid-based indicator, and allow that soil to absorb the acid that's there, and then dispose of that soil outside. Or again, in a waste basket with a plastic liner. Secondly, if we do have indicator that has expired and it's no longer working effectively, how do we dispose of it properly? Essentially, any acid-based component we can put down the drain. What you need to do, though, is turn the water on first, add this acid to that, pour it down the drain, and allow the water to run afterwards, and that dilutes the acid out. Never add small amounts of water to the acid itself. You can cause a violent reaction. So again, that's a very simple way to dispose of this, and then just put the glass bottle into, again, an approved waste container.